Thank you for tuning in to the Tony Show.
Marcher toute la journée et toute la nuit. Tous ces soldats de mort.
Get ready for the future. It's coming to you now. See there? It just passed you. Present moment becomes future moment, becomes everything we could dream. Dream your dream until your dream comes true. Do not stop. Do not give up. Here you go, Tony Show 2. And my goodwill, meaning nothing but let our dreams come true. The best things that we dream, make it happen. Bring your beauty to life and deliver it for the world. If we do that, we have less gray and more color. We need as much color as possible. When I was a kid, my dad used to sing a song called De Coloris, which is all the colors of earth. We need them all. I'm bringing mine, you bring yours. And let's fly with our colors, all right? Are you ready for a classic Tony Show clip from filmed in 1990?
I used to be Groucho Marx's chauffeur when I lived in Santa Monica. I was a chauffeur for about a year. He said, you know what, Pete? It's in the park. That's where it's at. That's the real act. The park. I didn't know what he was talking about. It's in the park. That's where it's at. That's the real act. The park. The park.
I've ever heard in the recent years in the Bay Area. This is what I listen to.
You're going to see some footage now that that was shot in real time from a lot of different times, but all around 96 to 97. So enjoy what you see and what you experience. I hope it helps to explain what I'm about.
Dad right now is
right.
He has Parkinson's, had a mild stroke, and is around the clock nursing care.
Right.
Let's see, work. Well, now the odd thing is, I'm going to be making a trip up to the San Jose area. There's a wonderful woman named Rosemary Landry that is raising 10 or 12 handicapped children with Down syndrome. And,
So, how did you beat Ralph Bronner? I wonder.
I've adopted so many children, I don't know which is biological children and which are adopted children. But I have dealt with, personally in my home, about 30 children on and off over the years. So it's not very many. The house is empty now. I've only got 12 children, so it was empty. I think the children get their strength from each other and having a large family there. After I've adopted them and they're in the family and they're integrated into the family, they suddenly get very strong. It's a pleasure to talk about them. When I was very young, I wanted to have a large family. I like children. I was the community person that would take care of all the little kids in the neighborhood and in England and take them for walks and do all those things. I just loved it as a child. In my house, I've got children who are perfectly normal mentally, that have physical problems, or I do have several children that are retarded, and it all blends in and it all works. And one of the things that I was worried about was some of the children saying, you know, when I'm at school and somebody doesn't like my child. We went through an adoption of an African American child, and for a while there was a lot of flack and the other children got it. But they are so protective of this child. She's just one of them. And you know, when did it get to be that, you know, only being one way was normal? You know, only if you're like me are you normal. I mean, that's a lot of learning. I love the differences. I love the differences. And in the children that I've got that are retarded, they are so special. And I wish I could be more like them. I can't teach them anything because they have got so much more than I've got. They've got total love, total caring. They don't hold grudges. They don't care about who's got the best car or anything. They just love you unconditionally. Isn't that a wonderful human?
You wrote the letter.
I wrote the letter. I was living at Saraha Buddhist Center, and there was a few of us living there, and I knew the Landrys, and I wrote to Ralph asking him if he would send some soap to the center and also to the Landry house.
So I called Rosemary to see what kind of person she was, and she impressed me right off the bat with her laughter,
yeah,
her British accent.
I told you, Fulham.
And the wonderful story of the children that she takes, and that her feeling was that she's blessed. No complaints, not asking me for anything. So then I asked her, who's this David that wrote the letter? Because that impressed me. You met him, I'll probably have it a little wrong, because what I got was that you met him 4 or 5 years ago when you took someone in for a brain tumor scan.
I took this one in. Yeah.
And you were the
x-ray
technician?
No, I signed him into the hospital.
And since that time, David has come over here and cooked for 10 to 15 people every Wednesday.
That's a hobo's lullaby. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow's always come and go. Tonight you have a nice warm boxcar. Safe from all that wind and snow.
David's become a legend in Rosemary. Up in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, where I live, David wrote me a letter in about August. What impressed me was he asked not for himself. He said, what a wonderful soap, and would we help two groups? Well, one was a Buddhist group.
The Saraha Buddhist.
Yeah, and it's fine. I sent them a case. The other, he said, for a wonderful lady that raises special kids. And I never go on that alone. I have to personally be involved. So I called Rosemary to see what kind of person she was, and she impressed me right off the bat with her laughter,
yeah,
her British accent.
I told you, Fulham.
And the wonderful story of the children that she takes, and that her feeling was that she's blessed. No complaints, not asking me for anything. And over the phone, that impressed me as much as it does here, that human beings care for each other that way, because you don't see it on television. On television, all I'm seeing is the rot on earth, every knife staring at me. And the good stuff goes unnoticed, unsung, or sort of one out of 100 things on TV. And This is the part of the world that makes us feel good. And it's right in this house now. I do this kind of thing because I love people. And I love people like this especially.
There should be a social consciousness to capitalism. That it isn't just profit, but profit.
There should be a social conscience to everything, folks. Keep on watching the Tony Show 8. So many guests, I can't tell you how many of them there are.
Hey! Everybody comes to Mac to get their cigars. And don't you forget it. I said, ink-a-dink-a-dee, a-dink-a-dee, a-dink-a-doo. Missy meat ink-a-dink-a-dee, a-dink-a-doo. Good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.
Thank you for tuning in to the Tony Show. I did the best I could to introduce myself to you, help you to understand what it is I'm trying to build here on Access Cable.
Sorry, girl, but I can't stay. Feeling like I do today. There's too much pain and there's too much sorrow. I guess I'll feel the same.
Thank you for tuning in to the Tony Show. Let our dreams come true. The best things that we dream, make it happen. Bring your beauty to life and deliver it for the world.
I can't leave that stuff back here. No way. I guess there's not so much more for me here today. I know I walk with all I've got in my hands. I know it's gonna be a long, long ride. Gonna fly over, gonna depart over the big, big mountain. Yeah, we're gonna fly over the deep blue sea. You and me. Wait till I get this ground to break up. Gonna plant up a big, big crop. Gonna fill the whole valley with deep blue green. Gonna build the American dream. You and me. Till we get this mansion full built, gonna cook up a big, big meal, gonna have a big party, invite over all of our friends, the party that never ends, you and me. We'll be right back.
case you haven't guessed, that was all old footage and not video. It was shot mechanically, not electronically, on Super 8, probably 15, 20 years ago, although I hate to admit it. Anyhow.
And wait till we get the kids through school. We're gonna go ball, gonna shoot some pool.
And my goodwill, meaning nothing but let our dreams come true. The best things that we dream, make it happen. Bring your beauty to life and deliver it for the world. If we do that, we have less gray and more color. We need as much color as possible. But anyway, this is a fantastic taste treat here. These are some old eggs that froze. With a very tasty, very, very tasty, with turmeric, sage, garlic, granules, garlic, powdered garlic, and organic powdered garlic and garlic granules. What else? Sun-dried Roma tomatoes, organic, a gift, donation from someone. All mixed together here. Now the frozen eggs were a trick. I discovered last week these frozen eggs. What happens with the frozen eggs? Well, if you do a regular boil with frozen eggs, try to make some basic hard-boiled eggs. It seemed like a no-brainer. Seemed like it would be easy, but because of the frozen yolks and something that happens while they're cooking, while they thaw, they turn into something very close to very rubbery, very, very dense. Anyway, this is so tasty. I'm loving it. Really, really enjoying it. This is a studio. No space to paint. I've got like 20 paintings in process. Paintings everywhere in process. A big landscape in process. A commission in process. An artist needs enough space to get up close to the painting with decent light. And then also to walk back to see the piece from a distance, and especially some of my color combinations, which are more inspired by Impressionism, where the human eye mixes the color. And the vibrant brushwork, oh man, this is so, so good. I'm trying not to cuss. Or, as I call it, speak French. When things are incredibly great, I say, wow, that's fucking great. Anyway, so good, so, so good. But I don't have time to eat it. Oh, we've got a break in the weather. And getting close to, see there, 30 degrees. 3 weeks ago, it's 9 degrees. Below zero, with 20 mile an hour wind gusts, which translates to about 30 below zero. So you got 30 below zero on the other side of the metal, and inside here, pumping that stove full as much wood as I possibly could, and babysitting it all night, not getting any sleep, but the heat rising and hit that metal and gets converted immediately into ice.
all the condensation. So I had layers of ice on the inside of that. And really, the truth is, inside here, those two or three days, about 10 degrees. But just trying to keep from losing my art supplies, my art materials. When I'm having this kind of an emergency, and I'm the only person I can rely on, there's no one to call. There's nobody going to come over here to be able to solve any of these situations. So you see the wear and tear in my face. It ages me. It's very stressful. I've had coffee with Steve Jobs in my life. Yes, I have. I've interviewed Willie Nelson and used to have lunch with Joan Baez. I've met some of my role models, Johnny Cash, Waylon Jennings, Chris Stofferson, interviewing him on his bus, the whole deal. You know, I've lived certain lifestyles where, in service to humanity, to try to make a difference, I've brought forth TV content that no one else could get from these people. So I'll carry the saw. I need to go out there anyway. This is a two-trip operation. I normally would not be walking out here with a camera. I can't justify it. That's why I haven't filmed very much. I mean, I've got like a huge handful of stuff and, you know, 50 pounds worth of stuff I could carry out into the woods. Or I could film it and carry it in two loads. And I never go anywhere to do work without the ear protection. And eye protection. Eye protection is very necessary. Okay, I get to look cool now. But don't be confused. I'm a 60-year-old mountain man looking very burned out. Hey, last night, I was feeling so happy the way people welcome me back online that I uploaded that painting, and I'm thinking about uploading this painting and maybe that one and that one. You know, a lot of good paintings. Anyway, my routine as a performer . Thank you for tuning in to the Tony Show. Thank you for tuning in to the Tony Show.
Warns thee about pleasing blowing minor D and C. Dark in the cinnamon marner. Shadows on the land. Certain individuals. They're not sticking to the plan. And I'm searching for a heart. I'm searching everyone. They say love conquers all. You can't start it like a car. You can't stop it with a gun. Leave it in the evening. I'm staying out of sight. Staying inconspicuous. Traveling the night. And I'm searching for a heart. I'm searching everyone. They say love conquers all. You can't start it like a car. You can't stop it. I heard that love requires a little waiting in line. And I've been waiting for you, baby, for a long, long time. I've been pacing the floor and searching the door. Searching the floor and pacing the door. I don't know, something like that. Asking for more, wishing for more. Meanwhile, I keep searching for a word. Searching everyone. They say, well, love conquers all. You can't start it like a car. You can't stop it with a gun.
Thank you for tuning in to the Tony Show. Get ready for the future. It's coming to you now. See there? It just passed you. Present moment becomes future moment, becomes everything we could dream. Dream your dream until your dream comes true. Do not stop. Do not give up. Here you go, Tony Show.
Feel how quiet it is out here? I love being here. On the days I'm here working, as long as I'm not feeding these fires, I'm trying to stay warm.
Today, with this quiet beauty of nature, so beautiful, I come out here for this reason. But anyway, but I think I owe it to the people that care about me to show them what this battle is, because it almost killed me this last month. This was really life and death this last month. There's a standing dead tree there. Nice, big, huge one. There's another standing tree there. Dead. Another one over there. Another one back there. And I've got these two. And when I cut a tree like this with a bad saw, which is yesterday, 2 or 3 hours, I want you to see this beautiful view that I wake up to. When I'm out here, I see, and I've just been studying it for the time I'm here lately. And paint this when it's lively in the spring, but hopefully if I get this heat thing happening, what I'm seeking is 40 degrees. So start the stove, heat up the studio. That usually takes 2 to 3 hours. You need certain things to line up for you. You need space to work around a painting, maybe 15, 20 feet in a 360 degree circle all the way around the easel. Look how beautiful this is out here. I want it to remain primitive. Get ready for the future. It's coming to you now. See there? It just passed you. Present moment becomes future moment, becomes everything we could dream. Dream your dream until your dream comes true. Do not stop. Do not give up. I'm here in my official capacity today. I am not my own person. What's that?
What is your official capacity?
I'm going to reinvigorate the vision for the Media Center for the 21st century.
I have a new saying for today. God gave me lemons and we turned it into cannoli.
People as beautiful as you are going to sell lots of cannolis. What is a cannoli?
What? What is a cannoli?
What the hell is a cannoli?
I'm not exactly sure. I've never had one.
But you're going to have one, probably.
I might try one this year.
Now, if I could somehow leverage myself to get a free sample of a cannoli, that would be fantastic. I'm going to find a way to get some later, by the way. I'm going to find, even if I have to, you know, I'm going to get some.
Just let me know. Just look
cannolis, man.
Cannoli. I think it's a pastry, cream-filled pastry.
There you go.
So
that's sure what I'm hoping for.
Full of sugar.
Yes. Yeah.
All right.
I'm going to get that cannoli, and I'm going to... It won't last. It's about time I caught up with you. You're just not working enough.
Yeah,
it's going to be done.
And then I think Jason worked it out that you're having lasagna.
Lasagna,
too, right?
Dude. I'm going to be so sad.
And the cheese from that we made fresh at Radiance Dairy. So it's Radiance Dairy Ricotta.
Sweet.
Made fresh just a couple days ago.
You will probably see some of Italian Fest, right?
I will be a part of Italian Fest.
Really?
I'm part of Team Cannoli.
Oh, seriously. What happens with that? Where are the cannolis?
They're going to be in the Sondheim Center because it's raining.
I love your t-shirt. I just can't, I can't help it. I have to film that t-shirt.
No problem.
Yeah, I feel better about myself living here now. Say something for the audience, man. Say something for the audience. Tell us how great it is.
It is. It's great.
How great it is to be a photographer in Fairfield.
Isn't it great to live in Fairfield?
Really? Is it?
Pictures of, yeah. It's a rich, diverse town. We love it. Keeps us busy, us photographers and videographers.
All right. John, I guess when you're the most famous artist in Fairfield, you know what I'm saying? When you're the most famous artist in Fairfield, you know, you got to live with it. Yeah. But you also have to show up and, you know, do your whatever it's called, you know, contribution or... Last year, didn't you do a Jesus figure?
Yeah, it was a Byzantine mosaic.
Yeah, beautiful as can be. I remember seeing it on Facebook. So this is the follow-up. Cool. Beautiful as can be, man.
Thank you.
Sweet. I'm donating my whole day today, but there's food. There will be food. Bottom line is lasagna. People as beautiful as you are going to sell lots of cannolis.
I'll just be stuffing them.
Well, there you go. Cool. Good to see you. This is a good scene, by the way. This is going to work out. You'll see.
Work.
For 3 months I've been free. So now I can show what it is I haven't been doing. And the cool part of this is seeing you... And then seeing you later with the
cannolis. Work!
It doesn't appear that you're suffering enough to
work.
Be working. Good.
What do you think? If we put this, if we set up a band in here, it'd just be awfully echoey. But it'd be fun.
Hello, hello, yeah. I called you, so I'm over at the Civic Center.
He's going to have a major concert in here, probably right here, right?
Well, I called Dick, and he said, well, we're talking about this, and maybe at noon.
I really wish this were right out there in the lobby, but they wouldn't buy it, huh?
I like having this big piano for Kilian. Yeah. He's got a real big voice. So.
Yep.
So we're doing a few.
I hear that Jason's going to be having some live streaming going out on that. They really seems like the further you go on this trail, the harder you have to work for a cannoli. It's just, you know. Although I brought it up to Dick, he said I should find him and he'll get me a cannoli. And I thought, wow, that's almost going to be impossible.
This
outrageous.
This is one of my granddaughters.
Wow.
Lana. Here.
Yeah, good to meet you. This is your granddaddy? Wow. Yeah, you're both cute.
I have five.
What?
I have five grandchildren.
Oh my lord, man. Good for you.
Three girls and two boys.
Wow. Beautiful. Yeah, that's fantastic. Well, I'm going to cross-cut the guys who I met and interviewed. Young guy, old guy, same guy. That's going to be cool.
Yeah.
Iowans, the few, the proud, the extremely attractive. Yeah. I feel better about myself living here now. They're 100% right. I'm so glad that I discovered them. Yeah. I'm using it for banter, but I don't mind if it turns into a cannoli. You know, if you get somebody like me, maybe you too. I don't know. You give me a cannoli, and next thing you know, I want two cannolis. So it's a slippery slope, you know?
Are you going to play the Steinway?
Yeah, for the opera.
Oh, sweet!
Cannolis are happening, he's going to probably be the one person I can't find to save my life. It's going to be good to see you with the guitar, dude. It's going to be, yeah.
I play every day in my house.
Good. And I get trampled by all the other cannoli gatherers. That shirt, if it weren't for that shirt goes to every gig, man. That shirt is on stage for every gig, correct?
Really? He always wears that same shirt?
No, it's...
It just hangs.
So you're rigging this thing up. Very cool.
Yep.
And this is called backstage reality. Most people don't even realize this stuff is happening. While out there, they're out there waiting in line for cannolis.
Yeah.
That's right. Oh. Nobody films this.
That's true.
Nobody can catch you guys doing this kind of thing. They get that other thing,
the
man.
Thankless part of the job.
Yeah, this is the hard part. This stuff's happening in here.
Working all the time.
He He's like very busy. This is all important stuff. This is, without this, the concert will not happen.
Kevin is a hardworking man.
I just.
It was like. They're unbelievable, heavy gear.
Fuck you.
Hey, I know that guy.
Yeah, he might know me too. And if you guys have, if you have a gun and he's got bullets, then you can get it all handled today.
I think Doug's after Dave first.
So Doug, we have Kiliano, and then we have. Jimmy Del Rio, which is the three people, and then Chewie's on the six.
Oh, okay.
So, Doug's on with these guys right before Chewie. So is Doug going to take care of me?
Okay, he's going to get some help,
That'll be great.
And he's on our, like, organ piano committee. So.
Okay.
That sounds good. Yeah, I just want to make sure.
So do you mind if, when you guys are performing, I'm back here? Yeah, so I catch some real good. No, I'll be the backstage guy. I don't know if I'd be stretching it to try to find a way to get a cannoli, but I'm thinking I'm going to try anyway. You know, cannoli and lasagna, I think it's complementary protein, or it's against the law to have just one. This is the real thing here. The backstage reality.
This is it. This is it. Absolutely. This is it. Here.
This is a real roots guy over here.
He is. Absolutely.
No. By the way, if there's something I need to do to become Italian, if there's something I can do now, I'll do it.
It's an outpatient operation. Your insurance should cover it.
So, it was a good year, huh? Even though it's rain?
You know, nice turnout, beautiful crowd.
To be honest, I think this is one of the most amazing years because, truthfully, this theater is where it's at. And there's a great, great outcome with the attendance. So, you know, I remember 4 years ago we had rain and we were working with a few spaces and it was scattered, but having a central hub for the future. Use the convention space again, Dick. Good job.
Yes. In fact, I would move the whole thing to the convention center in the street in front of here rather than this. But that's just my opinion.
I told Dick he needs to make a documentary with all the footage from the 10 years.
And that's possible.
You know, like have some history behind it and enter it into a festival. He's got a lot of footage.
Yeah.
You know, this was the first time we ever had an American summit for Italian bagpiping in the country. It was right here.
Yes. Ever, even when there were more Zamponiari in the States a generation or two ago.
There are people that are not with us here. David Marker, Todd Cambio, Lionel Botari, Gene Parisi, Gianluca Zamorelli, Sean Folsom. You know, all the people that have really made this through the years possible as performing too. I miss you guys this year. I wish you guys were all here. You know, big salutations. I guess we're
on. Are you going to go again? Yes. Good. Fantastic. You were great.
Thank you.
You know you were. Who am I, dude? Who am I?
I have no idea.
It's an illusion. I wish I could be converted to Italian, because if there's some ceremony or something, I would do it. Sign me up. You know, if there's something I'm supposed to know or do, I'll learn it in a minute, and then I'll be in movies like Al Pacino or something.
I'm pretty sure people have more than one. Cannolis are one of the most popular foods
for
at
Italian.
The event.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They're huge. People love them.
When I'm feeling blue, the guitar's coming through to soothe me. Thanks for the joy that you've given me. I want you to know I believe in your song. Rhythm and rhyme and harmony. I'm counting on you. You can carry me through. Lord, give me the beat, boys, to free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away.
Sorry, I played that at my dad's funeral, so it was kind of rough.
Perfectly fine. Very good. Thank you.
Well, I'm in this desert town, and it's hot as hell. But no one's buying what I've got to sell. I make my lame kid walk. I make a dumb guy talk. I'm preaching up a storm both night and day. Everyone just turns and walks away. I can see that I'm only wasting time. So I head across the road to drink some wine. This old man comes up to me and says, "I've seen you on the street. You're pretty good, if I do say so myself. But the guy come through last month, he was something else. Instead of calling down fire from above, he just gets real quiet and talks about love. I'll tell you something funny. He didn't want nobody's money. I'm not exactly sure what this all means, but it's the damnedest thing, I swear, I've ever seen." Since that time, every town's the same. I can't make a dime. I don't know why I came. I decide I'll go and find him and find out who's behind him. He's got everyone convinced that he's for real. Well, I figure we can work some kind of deal. He offers me a job, and I say fine. He says I'll get paid off on down the line. Well, I guess I'll string along. Don't see how too much could go. As long as he pays my way, I guess I'll follow. We're heading for Jerusalem.